Now, cult TV fans amongst you will probably recognise the lines, "What do you want? Information. You won't get it," as coming from Patrick McGowan's 1960s cult film called The Prisoner. Well, our next guest on Raw TV, Joe Banks, specialises in disinformation, which is also the name of his ongoing musical project. Strangely comforting, that, I think. That was the Bruce Gilbert remix of National Grid by Disinformation, a.k.a. Joe Banks. Hi. Joe, welcome to Raw. Now, you've been doing this for about 4 years, but
yeah, right.
Was your start, were you one of these boffin school kids whose bedroom was strewn with valves and circuit boards?
A little bit, not too much, you know.
So how did you develop from an interest in electronics and physics or whatever into actually perform or performance orientated stuff?
Just sort of realising that making radio recordings would be an interesting way of sort of sprucing up experimental music a bit, which is getting a bit dry and dull, you know. And that there are a lot of radio phenomena that are sort of, you know, good potential source material for making a horrible row.
So what's the appeal for stuff like this then? I mean, as I said, most people, you're not going to get it played on the radio to
any... it does get played on the radio a fair bit, actually. I mean,
but not the Zoe Ball breakfast show kind of radio, though.
It's not really sort of giving them any stress in terms of competition, I don't think, no. But, I mean, it does, you know, have a degree of mainstream exposure, but it's largely an underground thing. Yeah. The specialist nutcases only.
Do you have to have a musical bone in your body to it, or can you kind of take it from its kind of scientific origins, if you like, and know that something works well with something else to make a pretty...
I think a bit of both, really. Yeah. I mean, in the case of the Bruce Gilbert thing, you know, Bruce is actually a proper musician and he's done his remix, so you wouldn't be able to tell that he's a proper musician from listening to it, but I've done a similar sort of remix with Evan Parker, who's a jazz saxophonist as well, called the remix is called London's Overthrow. So I like to sort of, you know, I approach things from a more technical point of view and then sort of get these people in to sort of put their input into it as well.
It's all very well doing that in the comfort of a studio. What about live performances? I mean, I've seen bands like Add N to X.
Yeah.
And, you know, not exactly very visual, but still very gripping when it comes down to it, very atmospheric. I mean, can you perform live?
To some extent. I mean, normally what I do is basically a DJ set when I perform, but I have a few live elements involved as well. Sort of live radio noise elements of one sort or another. It's quite difficult to do it indoors because a lot of the phenomena are sort of complicated or overwhelmed by interference from man-made devices, so it's a lot of the recordings need to be made out of doors, the original source recordings, so it's difficult to do it in a performance context. They're just one or two things that you can kind of add to it live.
Well, we're obviously indoors in the lovely studios at the moment, and we've got this rather low-tech looking kind of thing on the
quite low-tech
floor called... called The Loop, and can you pick up Channel 5 on this?
I mean, what it's actually designed for is...
Here it is now.
Right, yeah. I mean, it's in this particular context, it just makes a fairly unpleasant row, you know, because it's picking up impulses from the TV set and the lights and stuff like that, but the purpose it's designed for is for picking up the sound of lightning strikes bouncing around in space, which is something you have to do outdoors in the countryside at night. But as you can see in this particular context,
it picks up all
kinds of other stuff, you know.
Also sounds like you can tell if you've had your ready break this morning as well, a bit of internal radiation there. So that's the loop. What other kinds of equipment do you use then? Is it all based on a similar kind of thing?
Pretty much normal radio
equipment,
you know, sort of fairly bog standard radio equipment. I just do very silly things with it, you know. As opposed to sort of listening to normal broadcast stations, you know. Sort of set it up near pieces of big industrial machinery and things like that, and pick up the signals.
Is it the equivalent of a radio ham, if you like, who's just twiddling at 3 a.m. in the morning, picking up all these obscure jazz stations from Luxembourg?
Yeah, I think of it more like a sort of form of wildlife recording, sort of like a really sort of sci-fi form of wildlife recording, you know, where I'm sort of making tapes of phenomena that people aren't really normally aware exist and then getting other people in to do remixes.
Well, tell us about sound mirrors, because I believe these were kind of the precursors of...
Radar. Yeah.
Is this sort of pre-World War I, is it?
Well, middle of World War I, they started developing them, yeah. You know, I've been interested in the history of early warning systems through my interest in radio, because radar is one of the major sort of historical stages in the development of radio science and radio
astronomy. I think we can have a look at some sound mirrors now. I think.
And these were the earliest form of sort of physical early warning system.
So this is to... It looks like something that Asterix the Gaul would be carrying about.
Yeah.
how did they work? And obviously, well, they don't go into too technical detail.
They basically used to get a guy to stand in front of them with a sort of microphone thing, and he'd point it at the surface of this curved surface and work out where the sound of zeppelins or planes or ships, which were coming across the English Channel, would be, try and get a sort of angular fix on where they were coming from. And they cross-reference a couple of these fixes to try and work out where they were. And we use this imagery for back projection at gigs and also for cover photography for some of the CDs. And stuff
it's
like
amazing
that.
How technology has condensed so much in the last 70 years. So something that was that huge can be probably fitted into
absolutely,
something
yeah.
that's about the size of this now.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the sort of radar installations have really shrunk over the years, and they're sort of down to tiny little computerized systems now.
And that was to do with the sound mirror, is that to do with some gigs you did in Scottish bunkers?
Yeah, there's a sort of network of nuclear bunkers that were designed to protect Britain from atomic attack. And because of the miniaturisation process, they've become obsolete. Whereas before you needed a room full of sort of valve-based equipment, now it's all down in a little box like this. So with the last wave of defence cuts, some of these places were sold to entrepreneurs and open to the public as museums, and I've done a couple of gigs in one in Scotland, which is a very, very spooky place.
Scotland and Dungeness. I mean, have you got any plans to play what you might term conventional venues instead of the far-flung bridges
hopefully
of the
not,
British
no.
Isles?
I mean, this particular one was great because it's underneath a field in Anstruther, so it's 40 miles to the nearest big town, and it's underneath. It's a huge office block buried under a field, absolutely full of weird military equipment of one sort or another, so... ideal venue for a nice concert,
But you have got a proper one coming up at the Haywards Gallery, is that?
Well, it's not really a concert, it's
right.
going to be an exhibition next year.
Yeah. Some kind of
they've asked me to sort of, put in some ideas for that.
And you're working on your new Disinformation album at the moment?
Yeah, title as yet undecided, but the last published one's called Al Jabba, which is a remix CD. It's got some great tracks on it.
Okay. Available now in all good record shops. Yeah. Look, under what section are you? Are you the ambient section, would you be in?
Possibly. I mean, Virgin Megastore, they do it in the jazz department. But,
Nice.
Yeah.
Swing it, daddy-o.